Grandma. I made Palmetero was the last game we were playing.
Well, I'm sure it wasn't a Cali football game.
Oh, but it was. This morning when I was helping Mom make breakfast, I dropped all the eggs on the floor. And Mom said I was trying to carry too much at once and I should go play instead. Everyone says I'm too small, and they're right. I'm too little to be good at anything, Grandma. I don't fit in anywhere.
Well, that's not true. God has a very special plan for you. He's even more too small.
Really?
Of course. Now, do you remember the Christmas story I read to everyone from the Bible every year?
Yes, that's the best part of Christmas Eve.
Well, I have another story to tell you. This one is about an angel who found himself feeling a lot like you are right now.
Really?
Oh, yes. And he felt like he couldn't fit in anywhere or do anything right. He was a lot like you. Come to think of it, if I remember right. Ah, yes. His name was Benjamin, too. Would you like to hear the story?
Oh, yes, please.
Many years ago, God's children were expecting the arrival of Messiah. They were expecting a mighty leader. Isaiah 9:6 says that the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty Father, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. The angels were getting ready to accompany the King Jesus on his journey to earth. But what some of the angels and most of God's children did not realize was that while Jesus would do mighty things on earth, his coming would be very humble indeed.
Attention, Heavenly Host. We've received a very important assignment.
What is it? Tell us, tell us.
Shush, Benjamin. You can't interrupt Gabriel.
How can you accept him? He's too young to know better yet.
I am not.
Now, Angel, let me finish. Y'all know we have been waiting for the day our Prince of Peace makes his journey to Earth.
It seems we have been waiting so long.
Well, that day has finally came, and you all have been chosen to accompany King Jesus to proclaim his arrival to the city of Bethlehem.
Oh, finally.
How exciting.
When do we leave?
We will be leaving from this spot at exactly 9 o'clock heavenly time. Everyone synchronize your watches. If you're late, we will leave without you.
They think they're so important. I'll just go and find my own New Orleans sash.
Thank you. you believe how boring it is this afternoon?
Yeah, Aaron. Nothing interesting ever happens around here.
Well, what do you expect?
Why would anyone come out here with us?
Yep, we're just a bunch of lonely shepherds. Not good for nothing but herding sheep.
Hey, there's someone here.
Are you sure we're not just seeing things, David?
Nope, there's someone there already.
Yeah, but he sure is dressed funny.
Well, we can point your bed to him, but I don't know anything about new kings.
Not that we even know who there was. We would be the last people anyone would tell such news to.
Why would that be?
Well, just look at us.
Yep, we're just a bunch of lowly shepherds. Not good for nothing but herding sheep.
And you seem like a very nice
person. You might think so, but you are the only one.
Yep, we're just a bunch of lowly shepherds. Not good.
Yeah,
not
yeah, we get your point, Jacob. Even shepherds' wives?
Even shepherds.
Yeah, who can point either direction? We saw a caravan of people passing by way over there on that path a little while ago.
They're probably on their way to
Bethlehem. You can maybe catch up if you hurry.
Yeah, maybe. If he had wings.
You'd be surprised.
Didn't the shepherds know he was an angel, Grandma?
They had no clue. They just thought
it was
just
a little funny
talk.
I feel sorry for those shepherds. They sound pretty left out of things.
I'm just waiting until you hear the rest of the story.
Hello? Hello? Over there. I've never seen you before, have I?
No, I.
Well, I'm sure I would have remembered if I had. I have such a good memory for people, you know. My name is Gertrude. What's yours?
It's Benjamin.
Oh, Benjamin. What a lovely name. I knew a Benjamin once, but he was much older than you. Why, I...
Excuse me, Gertrude?
Yes?
Well, I'm trying to find my way to Bethlehem. Could you help me?
Well, my goodness. Why didn't you say so earlier? That's where the caravan is headed. You know, we should be there before nightfall. I can't say I'll be disappointed to be off the trail for the night. Rheumatism, you know. What did you say you were going for? That's just lovely. We're all going for the census. Horrible bother, that census. Will you just stick with me, Sonny, and I'll make sure you meet everyone. I've made it my business to know everyone in the caravan.
Oh, really?
Just looky there. Here comes Rebecca and her brood of children now. They are handy. Come and I'll introduce you. Yoo-hoo, Rebecca dear. Rebecca, this is Benjamin. He's on his way to Bethlehem too.
It's nice to meet you, Benjamin.
And these are her children, Adam, Isaac, and little Lydia.
Say hello, children.
Hello. Mother, Isaac, push me.
No, I didn't.
Did you? I saw you.
Isaac, behave yourself. Children don't want to play now. Benjamin, I apologize for my children. They just never seem to let up. Oh, they seem like sweet.
And not to mention energetic.
With my husband away, I just can't seem to keep him under control.
Oh, you are a fine mother, Rebecca.
You know, there's no other job more important than being a mother, Rebecca.
Really?
Yes. Children are a gift from the Lord, and you have the privilege of raising your children to love and honor God. You're right. Thank you, Benjamin. It was nice meeting you, but I'd better keep an eye on my family. Goodbye.
Poor overworked thing. I don't know how she does it. Oh, look, here comes Peter. He's a nice old fella, but I must say he is a little crotchety. Oh, Peter, over here.
Gertrude, what do you want now?
Oh, Peter, don't get so fired up. I just want to introduce you to Benjamin here.
Nice to meet you, sir. How are you?
How am I? Now that's a silly question. Just how well can an old man be when he's unuseful to anyone?
Oh no, sir. He never seems to be useful to God.
Well, that's all.
she would really appreciate your help.
What could possibly do?
I bet her children would love to have someone tell them stories, show them interesting animals on her journey, or just pass them on when need.
You really think so?
I'm sure. Why don't you give it a try?
This might be it.
Well, I haven't seen either that turkey for the whole time we've been on this trip.
Every turkey is a real one they're needed.
Well, come along now. Come along. I have some others to introduce you to. We have two young couples traveling with us. Two more different pairs you'll never meet. Deborah and John are constantly bickering. You wouldn't believe how that girl can talk. Why, I've never heard of anyone going on and on that way. She just never stops. Have you ever heard of the light?
Oh, I've met one or two people.
And then there's Mary and Joseph. Now, Mary is the sweetest little thing you've ever met. And Joseph just dotes on her. Oh, look, there's Deborah and John now, and getting along as usual, it looks like.
It's like you're in John.
Deborah.
Hello, dears. I'd like to like you to meet someone. This is Benjamin.
So nice to meet you.
See how polite he is. Why can't you be like that, John? He never talks nicely to me. He doesn't appreciate a thing I do. And this whole hard trip, I unpack and cook and pack up again. And do you think I get more and more things? No.
Good night.
Oh, I'm sure.
And just once, you might think to pick me up some flowers and do something nice.
But I just bought you flowers the other day.
But I asked you to bring them to me so it doesn't count.
Oh, brother, I give up.
See, it doesn't even care enough to try.
I'm sure he carries, don't you, John?
Well, that's never. She seems to know.
Now, you too.
Well, of course I care.
Do you appreciate what she does?
Of course.
Then why don't you ever call?
I guess I thought she knew.
And Deborah, you don't need all those things you say to John, do you?
No, I just want to get his attention. I need to know that I'm important.
You were so important.
Oh, honey cakes. Come on, I'll make you something wonderful for lunch.
Oh, my, that was a whirlwind. I'm just speechless. I can't believe how you sparked them up. I've never seen them so happy, unless they were apart, that is. Oh, lovely. Here come Mary and Joseph. She looks a bit tired today. They're having a little one soon, you know. Mary, yoo-hoo, over here. You can see how exhausted she is.
Gertrude, how nice to see you.
How are you, dear?
I'm good, just a little tired, thank you.
Glad to hear it, dear. I want you and Joseph to meet someone. This fine fella is Benjamin.
Nice to meet you, Benjamin. Yes, we are, but I'm afraid the journey's been hard to bear.
Oh, Joseph, I'm fine. I'll just be glad when we get there. And are you on your way to Bethlehem as well, Benjamin? As a matter of fact, I am. I'm looking forward to it.
Well, you're more than welcome to come with us the rest of the way.
Oh, do that. It would be so nice for Joseph to have the company. I'm afraid I haven't been learning with laughs lately.
Not so. Your mind is just occupied, that's all.
I suppose.
Now, you all come along with me, and I'll fix us some lunch before we head out again.
Go on ahead. I'll just need a few moments alone, and then I'll come.
Are you sure?
Yes, go. Oh, Father God, I need your help. I'm so afraid. I don't understand your plan for your son. I feel so unworthy to be his mother. Please give me your strength.
Thank you.
dear. Lunch is ready.
Coming.
So Mary knew that her baby was God's son?
Yes, and so did Joseph.
And she was afraid?
Well, I imagine she wondered how she would be the best mother of Jesus. But God knew Mary's heart. He knew the best person for the job, just as he always does.
What happens next?
A little caravan was in for a big surprise when they got to Bethlehem. The city was so full of people that there was no place for them to stay.
Mary, I'm so sorry. I had no idea the city would be this full.
It's okay. I'm just glad everyone else had relatives and friends to stay with.
Mary, you all right?
Oh, Joseph, I'm afraid the baby's going to come soon.
What am I going to do?
Why don't you try the building over there? I know there's signs that's going to be, but you never know.
Can I help you?
We were just wondering if you might have a room, a little bit of room somewhere.
Hey, can you help me with some of this stuff? Oh, who do you have here?
These people looking for rooms of all days.
Well, what a shame that we're full.
Do you have a place anywhere? My wife. Benjamin, I failed her. I couldn't provide a place for Mary to have her baby. She has to give birth in a stable. A stable?
Joseph, at least you found somewhere for her. Others have not been so lucky.
But if I can't provide now, how will I provide later? What kind of father will I be? Why did God choose me for this task?
God knows what his children can get. He wouldn't have chosen you unless he knew you would be perfect for this job. Believe me, one would
be. Do you think so?
I know I know.
Welcoming your son. Where do I fit now? Do you have a place for me?
but I miss welcoming the King Jesus to earth. I feel God and his plan.
But Benjamin, don't you know? You've been with him all along. Our King has been born as a baby, Mary and Joseph. You didn't fail God. You're part of his plan.
Really? God sent his son as a baby? He's really right here?
Yes, and you could be the one to announce it. Do you have any idea who should be the first to hear?
Oh, I think I know just the one.
Mary, there are some people here to see Jesus. Shall I tell them to come?
Thank you. son of your Savior.
He's Benjamin, even though he made lots of mistakes.
That's right, and he'll use you too.
Jenny, you need your help.
You need my help?
Yeah.
Sure, I will. You bet. Thanks for the story, Grandma.
My pleasure, Jenny. Never forget this story. My God loves you, and I love you too. Merry Christmas, Jenny.
Merry Christmas.